This is the HTC Rhyme Take Apart Repair Guide. The first step will be to remove the bottom back battery cover. From there we can use a hair dryer or a heat gun to gently heat the upper part of the back housing. This will soften the adhesive, allowing the top cover to be removed easier. Using a safe pry tool, gently slide it along the outside edges of the upper cover. Once all the clips are released, it will still be held in place with adhesive. We can now use the Torx T5 screwdriver to remove the 7 screws as shown in the video. There will also be one small Phillips screw that will need to be removed. Using a pry tool, we can now lift away the model decal. And using a safe open pry tool, we can now remove the lower back housing. With the motherboard exposed, we can now release 2 small Phillips screws. We can now release the 2 antenna cables, the 2 pop connectors, and a single jaw connector. The motherboard can now be removed. Using a pry tool, we can now flip the upper motherboard down. This will reveal 2 jaw connectors, which will need to be released. We can now use a flat pry tool to begin releasing some of the adhesive holding the housing to the battery. We can now begin pushing through the screen assembly and battery from the front housing. Note that there still will be a large amount of adhesive holding the battery in place. We can now use a pry tool to release the volume button flex cable from the housing. This will simply be adhered into place. You can now begin peeling away the motherboard flex cable from the housing. We can now remove the volume button flex cable. Using a pry tool, we can now lift away the touchscreen flex cable from the back of the housing. Now, using a heat gun or hairdryer, we're going to heat the outside edges of the screen assembly. This will soften the adhesive, making it easier to detach. Be sure to thoroughly heat the back of the screen assembly, as there is a large amount of adhesive. We can now use a pry tool to begin releasing some of the adhesive holding the screen assembly to the front housing. Work your way through all the slots on the housing, releasing as much adhesive as possible. You will likely need to reheat the adhesive several times during this process. With all the adhesive released, we can now separate the screen assembly from the housing. Be careful of the touchscreen flex cable as it's fed through the slot in the housing. You can now replace your screen assembly.